apparently rail investigations are actually coming following the disastrous derailment of a train in East Palestine. The House is going to be looking into it. Multiple House committees gaming out what are considered to be aggressive hearings on the Biden administration's response to the train wreck in Ohio, including how the government supervises giant rail companies. And isn't this the only way that this could happen? So you have an actual crisis, it's train derailment. The House is going to investigate it, but the part they're going to investigate is something, something Biden. They have no interest whatsoever in the rail company. Why the rail company had a 1.5 mile long train. Why we still don't know what chemicals were actually on that. Why they only had 2 employees. Why they hadn't upgraded the safety features, including the brakes. All this stuff, the lobbying they've done to get the government to go easy on them. No interest whatsoever. An actual crisis, and it is, of course, only an opportunity to criticize Joe Biden. And if you want to do some of that, I'm actually perfectly happy to do that. I've been doing it in a lot of our videos. But take a look at what the Republicans do. They get into office and it's all running coverage for corporations. Francesca, what do you think?
No, exactly. And look, if they're going to criticize Joe Biden for preemptively breaking the strike of rail workers, that's fine. They voted for that strike breakage as well. So if they're going to hold themselves accountable to, like, hey, why did we listen to Biden when he was trying to break this strike with these workers who want paid sick leave? Yeah, we should redo that vote. Like, I'm all for it. Have at it, right? And if Buttigieg, if you want to criticize Buttigieg for not coming down harder on the rail companies again and not reversing the rollback, so reinstating some of these the regulations, please, please do it. But that's not what they're going to do. They're trying to paint this as like somehow Biden's Hurricane Katrina response. And it's like, no, it's not. It wasn't Biden who went and was like, yeah, here's what we're going to do, Jack. We're going to burn these chemicals. You know, no malarkey, malarkey being all these chemicals, burn them. Like, he didn't. It was the company that was able to not only get themselves and this town in this situation, but then deal with it in a way that arguably was way worse. Although, yeah. I don't know, might have seemed like a good idea at the time until there are radioactive squirrels coming out of trees and everything just feels like The Simpsons to me right now.
Yeah, I just hate it. James Comer, House Oversight and Accountability Chair, sent a letter demanding documents from Pete Buttigieg. Same day that Buttigieg was visiting it, saying the infrastructure failure that caused the derailment has led to an environmental disaster. Hey, look at, they're acknowledging environmental disasters.
Ooh, it exists.
The committee is deeply concerned by DOT's slow pace in resolving this matter. I don't even know what company was running that train, but I am very worried about the Department of Transportation doing.
Yeah, they're like, how could Biden do this to us?
This is why we so desperately need an actual progressive president and progressive governance, just briefly, to show people that you could have substantive, honest governance, that you could look into why didn't Buttigieg go there faster? I mean, that wouldn't have solved the problem, but it would have been reassuring at least. Why didn't the Biden administration push to re-implement the deregulation that the Trump administration had done? Those are perfectly legitimate questions, but also, why did the corporation do this would be a great question to ask. But you don't get that. You get this fake oversight, fake accountability that just serves to distract from the actual corporate responsibility that should be the main part of this conversation.
Absolutely. I mean, it's just incredible also for Buttigieg, who like has aspirations to be president. Like, what did you do in a time of need and one of the biggest environmental disasters, corporate induced environmental disasters of our lifetimes? You went and just said, we need to work with business. We need them to come to the table. No, you say there needs to be a cap on the length of trains, like their maximum, whatever, 50 train cars, not 150 train cars, always 2 people. At least 2 people. We are absolutely demanding that there be some sort of accountability for the people. It can't just be $1,000 a resident. Like, you come in there strong, you lay down the law, and then what's Fox News gonna say, John? What's Fox gonna say that night? Oh, he's being tough on corporations. Let him. We know how that's gonna ring with actual people, including their viewership. Yeah. So it's just, again, they're so good at doing the right is so good at performative populism. And Democrats are so bad, even at the performative part.
Yeah, no, if I could get one thing, maybe it would just be to get the conservatives to understand how they're being played on, like, again, corporate the populism of the right or whatever. So like DeSantis criticizing Disney for being too woke, that's not actual like accountability for corporations. That's not actual oversight. Like turning a blind eye to a what you're saying is a horrific environmental disaster is just maddening, man. Just maddening.
Mm-hmm. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.